What's up, everyone? KobanRani456 here today, presenting you all a brand new playthrough. Today, I'm going to be giving you my next Sonic playthrough, a game that many people have requested on my channel for quite a while. So here it is! And this is it, ladies and gentlemen, my next Sonic playthrough on my channel, Sonic Adventure DX for the PC. Really, really excited about doing this game, as so many of you all, my viewers and fans, have asked me to do this as my next Sonic playthrough for my channel. And, you know, it's so good to finally be done with Shadow the Hedgehog and move on to something else in the Sonic series. So if you all are excited about this playthrough and want to keep on seeing more, make sure to go ahead and smash that like button. Let's see if we can hit the like goal of 5,000 likes for the first part of this playthrough. And then, also, for question of the day, let me know in the comments below, what do you all think about this game overall for the Sonic series? Is it one of your favorites? Is it just good? Or do you not like it at all? Would love to hear your thoughts in the comments below. But anyway, we're gonna go ahead and start off a new game right here. And yeah, we got ourselves Adventure. I don't know what the... Okay, the trial must be the demo, and then there's Mission. But yeah, I'm playing the PC version of this game, so that's like in HD and all that stuff, as this game has been re-released on like 10 gazillion consoles. Heck, you can probably find a version of this game on the Sega Game Gear. That's how many times this game has been released. As you all can see right here, we've got ourselves six characters. We've got Sonic the Hedgehog, we've got ourselves Tails, Knuckles, Amy, and then the AIDS-ridden pussy, Big the Cat. And then we've also got E102Y, or Gamma, I believe that's what his name is. I thought that was a Y, but that's Gamma. But anyway, alright, so the only character that we can play in this game right now is Sonic the Hedgehog. So that is exactly what we're going to do right now. We're going to delve into his story. Let's get him!
Yeah! This is happening!
Huh?
What's up?
You are completely surrounded! Surrender yourself! Lock on target, man! Ready? Fire!
yeah! This could be fun!
Alright, so here we are, facing off against the first boss in this game, Chaos Zero. And this is our first time playing as Sonic in the 3D world. So yeah, Sonic can move around in all different directions, and he has a new move in this game called the homing attack, which allows us to home in on enemies. And what we're supposed to do right here is just basically home into Chaos Zero's head right here and take him out. But right now he's gonna actually go up to the top of these poles right here and try and, you know, wail down on us with his arms. But anyway, took him out with 3 hits, and he's been defeated. Beat him in 24 seconds, so pretty fast, dang.
Come on, you big drip! Where you going?
You know nothing, fool! It's Chaos, the god of destruction!
Oh my god. Eggman's laugh, Jesus Christ. Supersonic Sunshine?
Huh? What? Tails? Watch out! You're gonna crash! Ah! Tails! Ah, what am I gonna do with you?
Well, looks like Tails is being an idiot once again, so we gotta go save him. But anyway, here we are in the hub world of this game. Yeah, this is actually one of the first Sonic games to, I believe it actually is the first Sonic game to introduce a hub world that we can kinda explore around here. And it's called Station Square, so we got ourselves some humans, like right here. We can talk to this chick in the pool. What happened? I was swimming and I missed it. Yeah, so we're not really going to be interacting with too many of the humans in the game, as honestly, they don't really say too much at all. But, funny thing right here, look at this, we're gonna jump straight into the pool. It's Sonic X all over again, save me, Chris! Oh, hi, Chris, what's up? I'm Mr. Know-It-All, here's a clue. Grab the spinning rings, it's important. As long as you've got the rings, you'll be okay, even if you hit any hazards. Now you know. Oh, and don't worry if the view suddenly changes, it does that sometimes. Just keep moving in the direction you want. It may take a little time to get used to it, so keep trying. So yeah, basically if you talk to these people around here, they just give you a tutorial on how to, you know, basically control Sonic the Hedgehog, even though we've played this game numerous times. But anyway, alright, so we're gonna come over this way, and we are going to the first stage in this game, Emerald Coast. But man, this brings back so many memories to when I played this game for the first time as a kid. As when I was younger, I actually did not own a Sega Dreamcast. I was a bit too young at the time, and, you know, my parents didn't really want me getting into video games when I was young. But the first time I actually saw and played this game was at a friend's house, as he owned a Nintendo GameCube. And I could not believe that Sonic could actually run in 3D. Like, I was completely blown away by it. That Christmas, I begged for a Nintendo GameCube so I could play this game, Sonic Adventure 2, all the other amazing Sonic games that were released on the GameCube. And man, good times, man. Good times. GameCube was one of the best consoles ever in the history of gaming. Absolutely love it. Anyway, here we are. Free Willy! Oh my god, run away! One of the most iconic scenes in this game, to where a freaking killer whale chases after you. And it's just like, come on, dude, come on. You're not supposed to be chasing after me trying to kill me. What you're supposed to be doing is, you're supposed to hold me like the River Jordan, and I will then say to thee, you are my friend. Does anyone remember that, though? From Free Willy, the Michael Jackson song? I remember that. Like, orcas and hedgehogs were always my favorite animals. So, you know, when I saw this game have both, I was just like, oh my god, I'm in heaven. This is like a dream come true. And this is actually the first Sonic game to actually have Sonic go underwater in 3D. And I believe it's the only one, too. One of the only ones, at least. So yeah, kind of cool. Hope Sega will make some more Sonic games where Sonic will venture underwater in 3D. But god, I love this music so much. I love this stage so much. It's so fast-paced. It's such an excellent way to introduce you to the world of 3D with Sonic. And oh my god, whoa! Oh, nice. The shortcut speedrunning skills. Not bad. It will take you to panels 2 and 3. Alright, so we've got ourselves wall jumping grades here, where you can jump off those panels, and if you do that, you can kind of get yourself up to a higher pathway right here. Look at this! Scroosh! Going so fast! Oh my god! Gotta love it. And also, we got ourselves a spin dash, but anyway, there we go. We have completed this stage, and have found Tails. So I believe in order to actually get an A rank on this stage, you're supposed to be in like under 3 minutes, something like that. I can't recall. Anyway, there we go.
Hey Sonic! Long time no see, huh?
I'm just glad you're okay. What happened anyway? You're too good of a pilot to just crash like that.
That was a test run using a new prototype propulsion system. It's got a few bugs to iron out.
Why not just use my plane, the Tornado?
Thanks, but you gotta check out my newest power supply. Ta-da!
Whoa!
That face, though!
Yep, I just happened to find one of the 7 emeralds during one of my test flights. This thing's got unlimited power, you know. So I figured, why not use it to power my plane? Supercharged! You gotta come over to my workshop, Sonic. I've got something I've gotta show you. It's in the Mystic Ruins. The fastest way is by train. Let's go!
Alright, let's go, Tails! Whoa!
But man, the cutscenes are so funny in this game, man. Like, the character interaction, and then just how cheesy the dialogue is, and their faces too, like... Freaking Sonic's face just always cracks me up at times. Especially if you actually play the Dreamcast version of the game, to where it's like, the character models don't look as good as this game, the director's cut. Man, it's just too funny. It cracks me up all the time. But alright, so we're in the hotel right here. We can talk to this dude. Who the heck are you? Alright, can you actually talk to him? Alright, I'm the hotel manager. Call me if you need anything. By the way, if you want to visit the Chow Garden, take the left elevator. Chow are so cute. Yeah, so you can actually go to the Chow Garden. Actually, let me see. I guess I'll take it, if I can actually figure out how to get through it. Okay, there we go. Alright, so yeah, there's a Chow Garden. This is the first game to introduce it. And you can kind of fool around here, you know, raise your chow. There's a little fountain right here. Look at that, it's so pretty, man. Like, this is actually pretty cool. I never really did, you know, fool around in the Chow Garden when I was younger in Sonic Adventure DX. Most of my time went to Sonic Adventure 2, so if I don't remember anything at all, that's the reason why. And I'm probably not going to be, you know, in here that much for this playthrough, but just wanted to show it off to you all so you all can know where it is. But funny thing, it's something I actually wanted to talk about, you know, since... Wait a sec, what the heck? Okay, what the heck does it say? From now on, the casino's only... Oh, that's right, that's the casino out. Okay. If we come over here, though, we can actually go to the city. And, as you'll see right here, it's kind of big. They've got, like, a little fair, like, carnival right there and stuff like that. You can run around here. Their police car's blocking the way because Chaos was just there, you know, a couple of days ago. And, yeah, I do like the hub world around here a lot. You know, it's not a bad hub world for it being the first 3D Sonic game to introduce one. And, yeah, pretty cool. So if you actually hit these glowing orbs, it's kind of like a hint system that tells you what you need to do, where you need to go next. But, okay, what I wanted to talk about. So funny thing, as you all saw with Chaos in the beginning, Chaos Zero, does anyone else notice how he has, like, stretchy arms just like the Werehog? I wonder if there's something to do with that, like if there's secretly a tie between those two, because Chaos is like the god of destruction, you know, he's like the dark, you know, energy of Chaos. from the Chaos Emeralds. And that's exactly what was infused into the Werehog in Sonic Unleashed, which made him turn all hairy and have stretchy arms. So I wonder if that's a reason why both characters have stretchy arms, because of the dark power of Chaos. I don't know, just something to think about. Let me know in the comments below what you all think. But anyway, we're gonna go ahead and board the train and go to Mystic Ruins. But yeah, I never did think about it until I played this game over again after Sonic Unleashed came out, because I remembered how even in Sonic Adventure 2, he's got stretchy arms, which made him extremely good for combat in the multiplayer. And now here we are in Mystic Ruins. This is basically Knuckles' homeland. But anyway, what we want to do here is come up here. If I can actually try to spin dash up the ramp.
If it isn't Sonic!
Oh, God!
Look, it's a giant talking egg.
Silence. I am Dr. Robotnik.
Baldy McNose there.
Scientific genius in the world.
Whatever you say, Eggman.
Enough. I've got big plans. And now I'm gonna put them to work.
You're always up to no good. Now what do you want?
I want all of the Chaos Emeralds. Better not interfere, or else.
Or else what, you big loser?
Or else I'll take them from you by force! The hard way!
Alright, so here we are facing off against Eggman and his Egg Hornet, one of the easiest bosses in this game. Sure, he looks pretty daunting, but there's a pretty funny glitch that you can actually do. So he's gonna shoot off his missiles right here, but then look here, get ready, he's gonna try and dive into you with his drill. But see here, look at that. But all you gotta do is just spam the homing attack, skadoosh, and there we go. Dr. Eggman has been defeated. So yeah, a little glitch that you can actually do to take him out in pretty much like 30 seconds right there. Look at that. Gotta go fast.
Well, that wasn't so hard.
Oh, are you kidding me, Tails? You freaking dit. Jesus Christ. And Sonic's just standing.
Come on, Chaos. Time to eat.
Chaos? Oh no, isn't that the same monster I saw the other day?
It's just as the stone tablets predicted.
Yo, Chaos, it looks like you've been playing with your right hand a bit too much.
With all seven emeralds in here, he'll be invincible and work for me. Together, we'll destroy Station Square. And on its ruins, I'll build Robotnik Land, the ultimate city, where I will rule it all. Come on, Chaos! Let's find another emerald, shall we?
Yeah, dog. Can't let people see me like this. It's too obvious what I've been doing every night.
Sonic! We can't let him get away with this, can we?
No way, Tails!
Without more emeralds, the monster can't transform! So, it's up to us to get the emeralds before Eggman does, huh?
Alright, so kind of interesting thing I just noticed right now. He actually talks about Robotnik Land, which is the first time and the last time we actually hear of that, as this is the last game that actually introduced, called Eggman, Dr. Robotnik. As, you know, he kind of, I guess, later on accepts the name that Sonic and his friends bestow upon him, and takes it to his advantage and makes everything egg-shaped, so then he's going to be called Eggman. Gonna be called Eggman in the future, but it's kind of funny. Like, what the heck? Before Eggman Land was considered a thing, it was Robotnik Land. So yeah, I'm a firm believer and supporter of Eggman Land. I'm sorry, not Eggman Land, Robotnik Land. Screw Eggman Land. But anyway, yeah, so I guess that pretty much wraps up for the first part of this playthrough. Kind of short, I know, but I'll try and keep the, you know, future episodes a bit longer. I may try and keep, the Sonic playthrough a bit organized, and then for the other character stories, I'll try and, you know, like, mash it up together and, like, do more stuff per episode so I can get through this playthrough, you know, a bit faster than usual. But, yeah, so, if y'all did enjoy this video, make sure to go ahead and drop a like in the comment. It really, really helps out a ton. And, like I said, let's see if we can hit the like goal of 5,000 likes for the first part of this playthrough. Also, for question of the day, let me know what your thoughts are on this game. Do you like it? Is it one of your favorites? Do you think it's just one of the good Sonic games, or do you not like it at all? And also, let me know what you all think about the tie of Chaos and the Werehog. You know, if you think that's something that Sega's kind of secretly hidden, is never mentioned, or what. But anyway, thanks again for watching. See you all. Have a good day. Peace, Cabanermites.